Our second day aboard the luxury hotel barge Raymond began with a typical European breakfast. Cold cuts, cheeses, eggs, pastries, fruit, yogurt, and marvelous French coffee. And then it was a short cruise to Dormans. Along the way, we saw some other people on the river. As well as some of the local wildlife. After another gourmet lunch on board the Raymond, we were off for a tour of the vineyards, Haut Villiers, and Epernay. Sue offered breakfast to the local geese that came to greet us as we boarded our luxury coach to visit the village of Haut Villiers. Along the way, our guide gave us a very educational tour of the beautiful vineyards of the Champagne region of France.
Here I am in the vineyards, and my shirt says it all. Save, water, drink, champagne.
Chateau to my left is the Chateau of Vivic Picot. Very famous brand of champagne, and actually one of the first female-operated businesses in Europe. Her husband died of the Spanish flu, and she took over the business and did quite well until I think it was her uncle spent all the money. The vineyards you see all over the Chateau region are three types of grapes: Chardonnay, Pinot Noir, and Pinot Mignon. Interestingly enough, they're all hand-picked, and they have to do it within 10-day period of time. That's an ambitious task. The reason they're hand-picked is because they don't want the skins, which are blue or, you know, purple-looking, to contaminate the clear white juice. Champagne must be clear or white, and that's why they are all hand-picked. You'll also see in front of some of the vineyards the various lines of vines, roses, and that's kind of like our old canary in the coal mine, if you will. The roses are susceptible to the same diseases as the vines, and if the roses start to wither, they know they're in trouble.
Haut Villiers is home to the Abbey of St. Peter's, which has been destroyed and rebuilt 7 times, and that is the home of the famous Dom Perigon, a Benedictine monk whose work in winemaking helped to develop Champagne as we know it today. The abbey is also where you will find the grave of Dom Perigon.
We're in the village of Haut Villiers, France, and that's the high village, and it's also the home of Dom Perignon. You've heard of that champagne, I'm sure. But what you may not realize is when he came to this village, not only was he a priest, he was put in charge of the wine cellar. And he decided, since the parish made most of its money from the wine, that he would try to not only improve the quality of the production, but also the quantity of the production. And he came up with a lot of laws and studied and made champagne what it is today. Merci bien, Dom Perignon.
From there, we went to Fleury-Lenaire to tour the champagne cellars of A&J Demierre, a third-generation family-owned champagne house. We learned about the yeast residue that accumulates during the aging process and how the bottles are riddled, meaning stored with their necks down and turned a quarter turn every day to settle the yeast in the neck of the bottle. After the disgorgement, or blowing out the yeast, a bit of wine and sugar are added that starts a bit of secondary fermentation to add some more bubbles. We did get a taste of the first fermentation, and it was excellent. And then we went across the street to their tasting rooms to sample the final products. And of course, Sue was glad to meet their mascot and chief of security, Airbus. They have been awarded several Sélection au vin presque parfait, or a wine that nears perfection awards. After our tasting, it was a short 5 kilometer drive back to Eparnay for a tour of Champagne Avenue, where the major champagne houses all have their headquarters. And some people say it is the richest avenue in the world, perhaps more so than Rodeo Drive in California. And that's because the chalk caves under this portion of Epernay is home to thousands and thousands of bottles of the world's most premium champagnes. We return to the luxury hotel barge Raymond and a cruise to Chateau Thierry. We were surprised by al fresco dining that evening on the deck of the Raymond. Another great day of cruising the Champagne region of France.